This question goes to the candidates of Cameron. Consensus government naysayers consistently point out that the process has several flaws, such as not being able to elect your choice of premier, too many unchallenged seats, and no solid long-term plan for the Northwest Territories because of regional and community interests. The voter turnout is extremely low in many ridings. What is your view on consensus government, and do you think we should start looking at introducing political parties into the mix to try and encourage more political involvement and choice? And we'll begin with Tamleg's candidate, Dave Ramsey.
Yeah, thank you very much, Jocelyn. That's a good question for Brian and I this evening. I believe that we are still in our political infancy here in the Northwest Territories. We will evolve, our political system will evolve here over time. And I can think of some things right away that we can start to do to bring some accountability and responsibility back to the system. I've been an MLA for the past 8 years. One thing that really grates on me is the accountability factor. When the next government comes in, anything that happened in the last government that was bad, these guys will throw their hands up and say that's not our responsibility, it was the last government. Nobody takes responsibility. So I think, first and foremost, I think the premier should be elected by the people of the Northwest Territories. I don't believe for a second that a premier should become the premier of the Northwest Territories with 10 votes arrived at in backroom deal-making that happens behind the scenes that benefits only accrue to the members. They don't benefit the public in any way. That's a first start. Then let the premier select his cabinet. You'd get the best cabinet, and the other members would be on the other side to keep check on that government. And 4 years later, if that premier didn't deliver on the promises that he made, he'd be out the door. If he did, he'd get reelected.
All right. And Brian Sutherland of Cameron.
Thank you. I'd just like to... I'll try that. Thank you. I'd just like to address the idea of the premier. As far as I understand it, if we were able to elect the premier, the city of Yellowknife would dominate that process. Because of that fact, the other legislatures outside of this assembly would never support it. And I don't think they should, because it's such an important role for us to dominate. So I don't think that's actually the solution. I think that's another distraction. Many people don't understand how this consensus-style system works. I've gotten pretty good at explaining it to people. Essentially, everybody who is elected is the government. There is no opposition. There's no opposition at the beginning. There's no opposition at the end of the process. So if we are ever going to own our own government, whatever model of government we have has to include party politics, which is the medium that you use to communicate amongst each other and with your government and with your representatives. So almost everything that we talk about through this entire election is a symptom of the problem. The root of the problem is that we don't have the medium to communicate amongst each other before, during, and after elections. So there are a lot of exciting things when the model does change. It does not have to be based on the Westminster parliamentary system. And that's actually something really exciting